Tell me about your aunt Claire.
What does she to do with this?
Oh, she was after the treasure. Why?
Perhaps you can't hear properly. Twisted pain. A debt.
You're lying. She wanted the sapphire. She learned about the prophecy.
I'm tired of your blabbering. So leave me be or get on with it, you bitch! I swear, I'll get you!
Deal with me, quickly.
Let's go with me!
Hercules! Hey, listen. Sorry, it's late. My coachman left me at the end of the road and I lost my house. I apologize for my answer, Miss Ruffles. He must have thought you an intruder. What brings you here?
Jamie has been arrested.
For what crime?
Someone's accused Jamie of murder. Of course, he's innocent. They're after me as well.
You must be exhausted. Come, sit.
She couldn't have forced her way into the Tarana instead. You're quite wrong for 9 months, Miss Ruffles. It's really difficult to make your way here, being quite so happy. Are we ahead? Or that won't be for long. We'll take a provision of the bankrupt and we'll transport you home to face trouble. Oh, stay there. Lieutenant. We'll be taking this prisoner to our charge. My mother thought! Your Excellency, I must respectfully request that you return this man to my house. He stands accused of murder, high treason. A warrant has been issued against Scotland, and she's bound to return there to face trial. Of course. May I see the warrant? I don't have it in my possession, Excellency. You don't have the warrant. Then what do you have, Lieutenant Leonard? Forgive me. Captain Leonard, you must excuse my unfamiliarity with somewhat liberal practices of the naval service, insofar as the current rank is concerned. I'm afraid the army takes a somewhat more traditional stance to these matters, preferring to grant title of command only when it has been earned. Now, as to your request, if you are unable to produce the warrant, then what have you to support your claim against this man? I'm sure you must have some evidence to put forward before you dispossess him of his freedom. A member of my crew encountered this man in Edinburgh while in the service of the Crown, and can attest to the incriminating activities he sought. You see. Then I presume your witness has made an affidavit sworn to arrest you for a magistrate. May I see the affidavit? Having only just arrived, I've not yet had the opportunity. Lieutenant, Captain, do you mean to say you have neither warrant nor affidavit to support your claim? Surely you do not mean to arrest a British subject on nothing more than a scurrilous gossip of the lower deck. Your Excellency, I am satisfied as to both the validity of charge and the identity of this man. And as a senior naval officer on the books, I am justified under the Articles of War in my desire to take him into custody. Indeed, Captain. Were he captured at sea. However, your authority ends at the water's edge, which is precisely where my authority begins. And until such time as I am satisfied as to the validity of this alleged warrant, this man will retain his liberty. Your Excellency, thank you. Lieutenant Leonard. Seems I'm indebted to you yet again. For saving my life. Seems we've been indebted to each other so many times, I lost count. Until next time then. Goodbye, John.
Jamie and I arrived here. Jamaica. What's the deal? You seem to have omitted one detail. Why are you here?
I told you.
25 years ago, you dropped out of the sky into my life. And now again, you appear on my doorstep. Strange how fate keeps bringing us together. I never met another traveler, only you. You share a bond. Something even you and Jamie can't share.
Suppose we do.
I'm the friend that you. And because of that, I let my guard down. I sacrificed all for you. And still, you come into my home and lie to me. You've been lying since we met.
I'm lying to you, Venus.
I now see it was you who poisoned Colin's mind. You turned him against Dougal and against the Rising. I just didn't know how far you put the storm. So you thought, I'm for a Scot to sit on a throne.
I've done no such thing. Charles Stuart had his chance.
He's water under the bridge. I'm not talking about the new prince. I'm talking about the new king.
Venus, I've no idea what you're getting at. I was just as shocked to see you at the
Don't play the fool with me, Claire. You knew full well about the brands here, the sapphires, and that I was getting close to freeing my people from the tyrannical rule of the English. They're turning my home into its former glory, as God meant it.
I think I have to leave.
Stop her. Get your hands off me. This isn't kind to you, Claire. There's no one here to defend you, save the truth.
What is it that you want to hear?
Why have you been after me all these years? I haven't even been in this town for the last 20 years. More lies. Right before Culloden, coming back to my own time in 1948. You never leave your beloved Jamie.
I didn't want to. But he made me leave because we knew what was happening.
I don't believe you. Not even you are a partner, do you?
I was pregnant!
Pregnant? They left your husband.
For the safety of my child. You know how it was after 45. The bloodshed, the appearance. Well, I went back to Teresa in my own time in Boston. And then when she was old enough, I returned to find Jamie. But that was a few months ago.
So you're claiming you traveled through the stones 3 times and survived it. I've read better stories than Nelson Boone. You can have her. Do what you will.
Look, I have proof. Here, look. This is my daughter.
How could I be in these photos
if I wasn't telling you the truth?
She looks familiar. What's her name?
Rhiannon. You actually met her at the university in Inverness in 1968.
I didn't meet her. She was the way she was around the leader of the pub. That was your daughter.
And we were there the night that you went through the stones.
It was you shooting me.
I want to tell you about what happened at the trial.
I tried to warn you. Then you must have seen your husband.
Yes. Or what was left of him.
He was one of my favorites. Handsome. Such a lovely boy. To sacrifice is required, Claire. For the sake of the cause,
I never needed a sacrifice any time I went through.
And how did you do it?
I don't know. I think it has something to do with who's on the other side, drawing you to them.
That might be so. But I just assume it's blood. Girl can't be too careful. A 200-year-old baby. Imagine that. And your friend. I'll act it once. sworn to sleep. I would frankly examine the music for me. It's hard to distinguish friends from fools. I now see that we've been brought together by forces more powerful than ourselves. I shall retire now. I'll serve you to this room. Princess wanting me.
I'm with the temple. These time people are the gifts. They asked her to come.
Margaret.
She's the first one to truly see me. The man that I am, and I see her. We wish to be together. After tonight, you will go to my meet. There's a home there.
Is she in?
I have not.
Perhaps Margaret has. Is this Mrs. Abernathy?
She met her right before Gilles came back to the stones. She seems to be at a city under Jordan. Yeah, come on, Nina. What was I used to stick?
No, maybe just. tweeking, did you?
Yeah.
You don't believe Mr. Fox. Persistent arguments will be all in your head. Having said, you think it's clear or something?
Right now,
Cecily. Just want to play in the career. Cool one. In the late 40s.
Broken head?
More than that. Somebody tried to cut the snake's head clean off.
Very generous of John to use his influence to draw the warrant.
Yeah. Did we get those 10 to Scotland, Cecily?
He has to be home.
Where are we? We're returning Ian Street to jail.
We might not want to go back after all this adventure.
I don't care if he wants to or not. I'll deliver him to Ryan Rockyfast. Stuff him into a hogshead.
Don't shake your beard.
I'm sure he's grown since my life, Kingston.
Funny. You have some new white hairs here.
I'm with the one we have. I suppose I didn't have a full head of white hair for after these specimens.
No, it's different.
No, no different.
You kiss me. Kiss my skin.
You have very fine skin, Cecily. Like pearl. Indeed, you have a lot of very fine skin since I ever met.
That's more or less. I don't like it.
Well, I have given much thought. That's what I want to do to you when we arrive on dry land.
And what's that?
I've considered in great detail what I want to do to you. Should I have you naked, handbody, no one hearing, with enough room to serve you suitably?
Well, I'm willing. And there's certainly enough room. It has to be naked. Well,
I'll see that. So part of the plan.
Plan?
Hmm. Some private spot in there, some rolling yellow, and begin by sitting. So, yeah.
I suppose that'll be the beginning.
So what's next? I shall take you on my knee and kiss you.
So much for step one. And after that?
I shall lay you down, twist your hair up in my hand, taste your mouth, throat, and bosom with my lips. I shall do that until you start making squeaking noises.
I do not make squeaking noises.
You do. I made up that one.
There was a soft, rushing sound like the wings of angels. I felt peaceful. And bodiless. Free of terror, free of rage. Filled with a quiet happiness.
Coming full circle, in this episode, we did the same thing in the finale where we opened in a surreal state where it was Claire. The premiere of episode one opened in a surreal state. We don't know where Jamie is. We don't know what was going on with him. The story has to unfold. We did the same thing in the finale where it was Claire. She's wrapped in this for sale. We don't know where she is. Let's let the story unfold. And his first lines in the book are, I was dead. That's her first lines in the series are, I am dead. So there is a plan. We do, believe it or not, we plan this stuff out.
We do actually think about it. We don't just wing it.
We do that a lot. We just say these little nuggets and plan way ahead to put them in, and we're excited about, you know, being able to use that one.
So this was the last couple days of filming for the season. We went into the deep tank, which that we have there on the studios. It's a massive tank, and it goes to about 20 feet. We put Kat and Sam into the tank with the Frog Squad underwater camera crew, and they essentially went underwater, and Kat and Sam had breathing devices, and they would go down, and they'd get ready, and then we would yell, we had a microphone, and we would yell action, and they would lose the regular, they would lose them, and then they would come in and do the take.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls,
this season was absolutely avoided. We
took a journey, took a voyage.
Hemispheres, yeah. We voyaged across time. We voyaged across oceans.
It's like a pivotal season in the most literal sense of the word, because the show, entire series, like, pivots on the season, because the way that the finale ends with them washed ashore in Georgia, arriving in the New World, is literally the first step of the rest of the show. And we deliberately ended episode 8. There's a big pullback going across the ocean, going away. At the ending of the season, we go towards America, into the interior. That's where the new adventure is.
Just like one of the house of haste, if it's a good call, you'd be able to try to figure out you. Try to just let you inside of a dark oak and start to show us what's coming.
Joe, I'm sorry about your father.
If you hadn't,
it would be nice if they made another meeting.
I've never faced any consequences. But you have to face the consequences, don't you? You have to.
I didn't kill her. Please find that man. Find that man. You can prove it. I didn't kill him.
Perfect match. That's the last twist of the knife, Jack. Your refusal to admit what you've done. It was you. Your fingerprints are mixed with your mother's blood. No one else's. Yours, Jack.
Let's round up the fatty car, slit its throat, sport, play it of blood.
Shambles of wedding, I'm going to head back to my view. I'm new to Taylor's, I'm going to have a bloody secretary. Team of the ghost, this is going to be Mrs. Vegas, they're not going to be assisted.
We kind of
spot room for just about the rest of your life.
I don't know why I ever expected it. You never help. You just stole off. To Korea. To your new life in London. It's all right for you, but the rest of us have to stay here.
Korea was a war, not bloody holiday.
Are you going to help save Daddy from life, yes or no?
No.
Jack, I've done it.
Best man, Mary, isn't this wonderful? He's come home.
Wonderful.
This gathering tonight, I absolutely will not mind if you slip up. There's something people think, and since the wedding itself is only going to be us. Do you think it's too soon?
Was it?
Me marrying you. Mary's not taking it particularly well.
She didn't say anything to me.
I'm happy for you. Well, that means a great deal. A very great deal. Esther is giddy to see you. Prepare yourself for answering.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be the same without you, sir. I missed you. Very much.
Michael, Christina, these are your new sisters and brothers. Mary, Esther, and Jack. They will report to you too. A good bath, tea, and then straight to bed. Ah. And this is your new daddy.
Hello.
Hello. I say, I do hope that's not the dress.
No, that's going to the hotel in the morning, so there's no danger of you seeing it. It's white, and that's the one.
Look who's here. Door, Esther, please.
Okay.
We'll still be there when we got some
door. Come on, the team's come tomorrow. Take your morning fits. Hello, by the way. I'm so glad that you couldn't make it. Where's your instrument?
My instrument.
Your cello.
Why do
you think something's wanted to wear?
No,
oh, God's sake. What is the matter with people?
This
is a formal occasion.
We can find something for him to wear. I'm not a musician. I'm Arthur Cullen. The man in the car. I'm Jack Arthur. So where were you going when Jack stopped you? What were you late for? A dinner party. I'm afraid the cliche about absent-minded scientists is true. It's been 18 months since my wife was killed. Why have you not come forward before? I was away from my work. Just asked questions. A research station in the Arctic. The Arctic. That's why I didn't see any papers here, any radio reports. I only got back in the last few days of this and being wrapped around some equipment on the table. You went to a dinner party, so you were wearing a dinner jacket. That's right, this will be absent if you could have a jacket, back jacket.
I wish I could go here soon, but I'm here now. And I'm willing to go on Earth in court. Since somebody will discuss this terrible crime, Mr. Arthur.
We've had a lot of people coming here claiming to be Jack's alibi to know something about him about our family. All those claims proved fraudulent.
But obviously,
psychics, tarot readers, a water that they attacked with lots of greedy, venal people. Fame seekers and charlatans that you can imagine the hurt and distress that caused.
It must have been awful. But I just wanted to do what's right. Jack was in my car. He's innocent.
Well, once again, you're too late. Jack died in prison before the case had come to trial.
He
doesn't have. He got into a fight with another inmate. Jack was a difficult young man. We loved him, but he was difficult, disturbed. We hope he's at peace now. And I hope you'll leave us to our own hard-won peace.
I hope that one day you might understand what he done to us. I hope your brother might one day be sorry.
Actually, we're all on business, so if you wouldn't mind. Yes, of course. I don't suppose you have any hotels or boarding houses nearby. There's a hotel in town. Good day, Dr. Campbell. We'll come back. There's something for you. No more information than he read in the newspaper, like all the others. He said he was wearing a dinner jacket, so we know he was lying.
I thought this had stopped. Why are these ghouls? Just leave us alone.
He told me he's a physicist who's only just returned from an expedition to the Arctic, which has got to be one of the best ones yet. Forget about it. This is not going to shake us. Esther, take those boxes upstairs. Kirsty will have tea on the lawn.
I'll take my
own.
As you wish,
Lieutenant. Strange. I like that. I look a little time later. Very strange.
Well, that's it. Forget about it.
Perhaps we'll look at the trial. It brings all back, doesn't it? I'm just a little.
before, dear.
Doctor. There are two T's, Michael. Two of them. Christina can do it.
Butter.
Why can't you? Butter. Bottle. Stand up. Look me in the eye and say it. Bottle. Give me that. Cousin Michael's had a little mishap. A dab of disinfectant.
I said he was innocent.
I'm standing on the cop. And the other problem was just six. I'm going to hold it too hard. You didn't want to think what a jack was going to do. Why? I do. I think about all the time. What if that was the innocent? What if he was innocent? What if he hadn't had it? What if Dr. Calvary?
Why? Leave it. You don't want to change anything or bring anyone back.
So I hide up here. You can't make me help. Hurry back.
being spent in the company of the father's friends and their bloated pig wives, railing at my hair while my face is crotch level. Not my bit of fun. I'm just going to go and have a quiet supper in town.
Ah, yes.
Are you drinking too much, are you?
You look very pretty. Don't let me let the men flirt with you, will you? I'll see you later.
I'm honestly not trying to take your woman's space, man. We'd like us to be friends. We can have shopping trips, lunches, just ourselves. I don't want to be your friend. And as for taking my poor woman's space, if your elocution lessons and your pallid brassiers, you don't have a chance. I'll look at you, playing into my heartbroken daughter. Poor mother. The thing is, no one hated her more than you.
Shut up.
Thank you. What are you doing? We've got guests. Quiet. It's just that it's my last evening here, so I've got to just
need to change into your going away outfit while your husband is still sober enough to walk you out of the house. What's the rush? Why can't you just say what you want to?
Because it doesn't look right.
Oh, that's what matters, is it? Looking right.
Don't get back to me if you don't need to change. You are happy for me, mother, aren't you?
What can that? You want my suit. Come on. Oh. One day. One day, just to crack the shell. See if there's anything inside. I'm 5 or 7 pounds, but it's called to Arthur, Arthur, I like my dinner. I thought at least one person in the family would be hospital. What do you say? Thank you. It's funny, isn't it? How some mothers fly. My mother, I know nobody really cares. Mothers make a lot of noise. Well, let's face it, a lot of the people that get fired are going to newspaper names, free, pretty much sit up before toasting my head. Especially when the mother's narrative. Jack was adopted. He has got his little one. Even the maid is also his old family home. Yes, it could have children, so they filled the house with little unwanted, dandy with their bums and buttered with their mouth on it. What do I say? Me on very short comment. I mean, the man gets himself a little bit of death. Instead of going to have to help a chap out, fine eggs, decorated. A bloody era. Whole world tilted on my way out. I was a god. Now I'm pissing a bottle. Jim. I tipped an extra. Don't I? Yes, I only got out of hospital the night before Rachel's sad demise. I broke the car off on the way back from the races. Broke my bank. I'm sorry. So am I. So well. Think about changing up the new Mrs. Argyle. If it gets difficult, you just let me know. I have news here.
Difficult?
I wouldn't like to see you get sidelined because I devoted to Rachel. So, what are you doing in the Arctic today? I'm not able to discuss my work. What I'm going to do, you understand? Official secrets. Well, you want to be quiet. You know, I was listening these days. I don't like to see. Jack's brother came to see me, Nicky, and what did he want, eh? He suggested that I leave and we'll come back. How typically charming of him. Ah, you got to go away and then come back. Let's see what else I can do. Jack's dead. I can't do any good here. There's an awful lot of good we can do there. What do you mean? What things did well about that? Tell your version of events. I didn't want to do a place like this, which was run riot. What bloody family assessment. Which one of them got blood on their hands? So he should swallow it. Sure, no, 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 no,
extortion. I won't do that. I can't believe you'd suggest such a thing. I'm family from their grief. If I tell a newspaper or a lawyer, it will be about me.
Shit, shit, shit. You're a scientist who's secretly searching out.
That's where I've been.
Some of us have said funnel. It's something that they can't face. You can look at me. That's just one thing. In prison. Yes, my dad has been a check.
I've been in a fight.
You're a con man. You've been inside your wallet. You're just straight back.
Crossing the terrified.
I'm so scared. He's attacking me. The boy on the wheelchair is attacking me.
Different. I would like to say thank you to for agreeing to be my wife. No. Which I think is happening quite soon. I would like to say thank you to my children, all grown up now, giving us their blessing. Thank you for being here. You have been steadfast during the most appalling ordeal any family could endure. And you have the gratitude of myself and my children forever.
Hello.
Is raging.
There's a new shepherd down.
That's true. That's also true. What if I become a big and tall wolf?
I'm afraid we're not currently looking to take any clients.
Right, sure.
I like a lot of things about you, but that is up there, like that is near the top.
It was your fingerprints mixed with your mother's blood.
I didn't kill her.
It was a lie in the house.
I'm the man in
the car. Arthur.
I'm
going to get you. Jack died before the case went to trial.
Jack was adopted. God has the law.
I would like to say thank you for agreeing to be my wife.
No.
Discuss my work. Official secrets.
Jack's brother came to see you.
I need you to go
and leave our car once you've gone. You'll have to take big 50-50 bit.
That's extortion.
Which money is taken out of their hands?
Rachel.
Of course not.
They must be blind. Your father enjoyed himself, despite that old chap turning up yesterday.
He seemed to.
Nice, isn't he? You know, I'm going to do all I can to make your father's wedding day memorable.
You're in a good mood.
I am, Arthur.
I know what to make your brother, but I still help. I can clear his name.
Leave my family alone. Leave my brother alone.
Which one?
Because if you want him to be killed, you should be one.
Why do you believe me? I can introduce you to
morning, everyone. I just have my first cup of coffee here, and I'm eating my morning toast. And then I turned on my video camera, and of course, it's not very attractive to be chomping in your ear. Okay, this repair worked out excellent. This one looks wonderful. Might just leave that little patch of fabric like that as is. This one doesn't need it. I'll touch up with a paint though. This is getting to where it's starting to need it. Pretty solid in there though. Back here, it's okay. This starts to feel like it's pulling here, but that's because the more paper that I put on here, the more pressure it's putting on these seams. And that's why I'm having to do all the repairs. And this little guy has been flipped open and closed so many times. Pretty good there. I need to bring in some paint here, bring in some paint there, but everything initially looks pretty good. Stabiloing is done, the coloring is right. Loud mouth. Everything's holding up okay. That will still fold tightly. This page will always permanently be bowed from those two elements. So just have to make sure that this is strong enough, which it doesn't look like it is. What have we got in there? It's like black tape. Jeez. Because that's going to put a lot of pressure on that. This page is almost done. Need to drop some color into here. This is Distress Ink. So I think it's a re-inker in Espresso. But I really like it for getting into the backsides of this white. So y'all know how I hate white edges. You see what I'm doing with my hands there? Make sure it's clean if you're doing that. But you make a little balance. It's what the sticks were that the masters used to use. It was a balance, a place to rest their hand. It would be really sad if I had to go over this again. I don't think I will. It's just so much. We'll see how bad it gets. Alright, obviously I did not get to this side when I was doing my finishing touches the other day. I'm just dropping the espresso down in there where I would have wanted the stays on to get. This espresso is a very nice warm color, even though it's very dark. Definitely not black. I don't even know if you can see what I'm doing here. So why am I taking the time to make sure all the edges are painted? Well, because that's how you finish a piece. You frame it. In my world. You certainly do not have to do it in yours. I like how it looks. In my universe, it's all that matters, right? Liking how it looks for you. Smudge it up. This ink doesn't really like to dry very much, obviously, since it's supposed to be on an ink pad. I wouldn't want it to dry out super fast, so it makes sense. You just have to be aware of the properties of the medium that you're using. As we know, the O'Keefe page has a lot of this on it. So that just goes with her just perfectly well. I don't know if I've tried to peruse the book for a while here. Let's see. And just to think, I haven't even gotten all the embellishments done. What? On my other pages. This is truly an epic piece. It's like you're doing it the way you would have done one of your paintings. And that's absolutely true. I used to paint 3-foot by 2-foot canvases. And I would end up painting them with a tiny, tiny brush like this. Because I could get the detail that I wanted that way. So since this is ink and not Stabilo or marker, I can really blend it out where I want it to be. Now, if you know me, you know I'm going to go back in with paint and highlight through here. Let's see, this side was painted, and then I think I put pieces over the top here. Where I just made this building sit behind this building more. And we're going to do the same with this guy. You always have to keep adjusting. And truly, this is more futzing, probably, or perfecting. I need to not call it futzing, because it is truly... If it wasn't adding something, I wouldn't keep doing it. Okay. Beautiful. Beautiful. Needs help. But it's going to be painting help. That's not paper help. I can't help it anymore with paper. This I like. This is still really hidden. I'll brighten that up a little bit, maybe, if I can. It's that pattern that's under there. Between the pattern and the 15 layers of paint paper that I put on it. Okay. Now, started to do this side. Now, this is done with the stabiloing and the painting and the coloring, actually. This is pretty well done. This is not. So, let's get something to work on here. As you may recall, I made some adjustments to this side, which I like these much better, the way that's set up. Yeah. I'm gonna fast forward you. That way I can eat without worrying about chomping in your ear. And you're gonna need to be fast forwarded anyway. So.
Really tight. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Ah!
Okay.
don't stick.
I'll go ahead. Set everything up for you.
Give me a lift.
Back,
I have to do the right thing. And I am telling the truth, but I have been lying. On the 24th of December, 1954, I was admitted to a psychiatric institution. Here's my will. I got out. I stole a coat and I stole a car and I was stoned. I met your brother on the road. I drove him to the town. And I was caught. Of course, I was caught. I don't know why I thought he'd get away. It wasn't myself. I was quite distressed. And that's where I've been for a year and a half, not in a research station, not working. I've been in an asylum. I was released yesterday.
What were you wearing when you met Jack?
Hospital issue pajamas, delivery, and straps. Miss Argyle, I have to speak to your father urgently. It's so important.
Thought he was a con man. I kept saying goodbye. What if Chuck was telling the truth? What if everything was not? Here he is. So what now?
Steal it from us.
Not
through, I'm afraid. They're afraid that Lydia practically forced something on me.
Well, why would she give you money?
Because I've been fucking her.
She gave me something special to me once, but she's a stalking horse, isn't she?
Jack, that's what I just did. It's all for your time.
Very keen on orphans and neglected children.
Yeah, that.
You try so hard to report that you're such a godless fraud, mother. Smiling, there's nothing wrong. But you've got the nuclear bunker in the center of the bomb star for it, so I know you're terrified. I know you're a mess.
Yeah, just a bit. Stop smiling. Stop pretending. And return. I'll stop.
You won't bring me, Jack.
One word against me, and I'm warning you. I don't care if we are friends, Bill. I shall have his head kicked in half. Every bone in his body. Say anything about your offer to help you blackmail this family. I don't want to say your wife.
I don't know what you've done. What? You just dropped. Checks instant. What? There isn't.
Better served. Family reading.
No, you're back there. I'm just going to take myself away.
Should I fetch me a free?
I realize that my history of being unwell makes me an unreliable witness. But the hospital in back of my sense, the time and manner of my insomnia, the time of my capture.
Are you quite well now? Not fantasizing the same things. Right. Oh, really? So you've been sealed?
I really was meant to be down there. I was part of the research team. But obviously, yeah.
The question is, did Jack didn't kill Mother? And who did?
There was someone else here.
Someone else?
There was a car parked on the road. I had to swerve to avoid it. It was a sewage car. And it was retrocessed. Small. Brown. The owner of that car, found the person who did it. Or at the very least, knows something about it.
The brown car. There's a shortage of them about.
It's a storage. The fact that I'm too late for Jack is unbearable. But I can clear his name. I can do that much. The true thing.
Well, my sister will be here first thing in the morning, and then we can begin clearing Jack's name.
I think you're a very honorable man.
I'm not. I'm really not.
You shouldn't see her, Mother.
To just roam about.
Where are you going?
Ryan spends the night before her wedding with her groom. And I wasn't even in the house that evening. So, I don't see why I should be subjected to an interrogation if it's all the same to you, Mary.
Yeah.
You told us you got rid of that car because Mother had given it to you and the memories had too much. They did. Or were you worried it might be recognized? Because in the dark of the fog, your red car might easily be mistaken for brown.
Say, please! Once in your life, see it.
That is blind to you. And you. Who it has been. I am not. It's an unusual place.
Good morning. Okay, I had a question asking how many pages were in here. And, I've only got a couple minutes, but I haven't counted. So, we've got this main page. Let's see here. Oh. Which is bigger. Oh gosh. Okay. So there's one. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven, eight, nine, 10. So, to construct this, though, it was one main page. This was... This for sure was a main page. This for sure was a main page. So there's three possibly four. And then this was taped in, this was taped in, this was taped on, this was taped on, this was taped on, this was, and this was. So as far as main pages into the book originally, I would actually guess three. And really, truly, if you're making this, that's how I would do it. One big one here, one middle one, and one big one. Okay. Then you can add on as many flaps as you would want. So you could take those three main pages, and actually, if I were to do it over again, I would probably do, see this set here, this two-pager, and then add this and this on. And I wouldn't put this and this in there. And I would take this second two-pager, and I would add two more flaps onto it. I doubt I would stick this little extra piece in here. I went overboard, fully admit that. And then this being your third two-pager, right? And then you can add on from there. So truly, you have your front and back two pages, and I would just start out with truly just the one, two, three, and then build down from there. So as you can see, this guy, it's a prime example of how I would suggest to do all three pages. Okay, so that's your update for today. All right, everybody, I'm almost done. I am going to go through and do some more painting like I did over here. Bring in some more highlights and brights into the vegetation. But it's getting closer and closer to being done for me. It's been just a heck of an experience, that is for sure. I love how my church turned out. This piece is a little bit strange here, but you know, it's got to be a little bit strange too. Just finishing up on this house, I'm in the middle of stabiloing it. You can see where it left off and where I need to complete it. I just added this little piece on, needs to be stabiloed. Definitely need to bring in some definition in the trees. Put a little bicycler guy in there today. So this is kind of where I'm at. The insanity continues. All right, I gotta go to work. But that is where we are. Twilight in the city. And I will do a cityscape page in my Back to Basics to show you how I would do this if I were to do it over again. Which I'm not going to do this over again, because this was taken as much time as it would have taken for me to do a 2 foot by 3 foot canvas. But I do love the effect. That's cool.